potential.
For sure.
A lot of work goes into getting one of them.
You better get it.
Yeah. Come on.
Please.
Downstairs, Zach. Downstairs. He's tired.
What'd I miss?
Oh, you're missing nonstop action here. 178 pounders. Stop noting it, buddy.
But I tell you what, the guy here in the blue corner looks like he's dressed a little bit better, so we'll see. And he's from the Army, or at least sponsored that way.
I don't know. I think he just borrowed those. They're black and gold.
Could these be a couple white-collar brawlers?
They might be too young.
Ooh. With the... Nice. He's a softball. Nice. They banging. Woo. Yeah. Wow.
178 pounds.
They throwing with mean intentions. This one guy's from the Bronson house. Is that a halfway house? Or is that just...
I don't know.
Wow. Never heard of it. Tough. Ooh. Wow. He just got caught with a straight left. See, that's why people don't like to fight softballs. They do everything backwards. Wow, hit little headbutt, little straight left hand.
Oh, yeah, they're both trading those.
Yeah, now they're trading. And a lot of times, too, in the wintertime, when you don't get that tan, you can really see where the punch is laying. You know?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Especially in the face there.
Wow, nice right hand. And that's what works with a softball. Straight right hand and the left hook. Straight right hand and the left hook. Okay. If you're going to throw the... Ooh. These guys is just looking to load up.
They are. They're looking for that spot.
That ain't exactly a lightning rod sulker jab. Oh! Was that a hurt? Did he get hurt? Did he get staggered? Is that a standing account?
A slip.
Okay. Call him a slip.
A slip.
Maybe he stepped on his toe.
He told the ref right away. He slipped.
Ooh, good body shot. Ooh.
They're just trading him.
Ooh.
Again. Tired than what they are. They're doing a good job.
That sack out of the blue corner had him a little bit on the ropes there. Even though he's wearing a red headgear, he's from the blue corner. Looks like they tired out a little bit here, Heather.
Just a little.
Well, at least they're fighting right in front of us here. We're not missing a thing.
We're seeing everything. I'm glad sweat's not flying over here.
Not yet. Not yet. One more run.
Yeah, right.
This should be it here. So.
We should be good.
They walked away because of you.
Other side.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Whoa, got a little wild there.
Yeah. Saved by the bell. Well, at least fast the blue corners went, and there was a lot of red at the beginning.
Three out of the last four. I think it has to more to do with the fighters, though.
All right, Al Levine, the talking machine. If you want the green, you got to come see Levine. And I tell you what, when I'm in Steubenville, Ohio, and I'm at the gas station, I see this young guy, Glenn Mitchell. They love him over there. Real nice kid. But, you know, my favorite fighter of all time is Matt Conway.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Matt Conway. Some folks been fighting 2 or 3 years. Matt Conway's been fighting since he was 2 or 3 days old.
Wow. Out of South Parker.
Out of South Park. He's actually the team wrestling captain of Baldwin High School this past year.
Wow.
So he's in great shape. Look at him. He's a technician in there. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So we'll present.
Good right hand by Mitchell. Mitchell is tall.
I'll hold the runner-up. We'll let Smoke and Jim do the champion.
Okay. And you'll have Rosie up.
Real thin, wiry guy. Conway's putting the pressure on. All heart. But Conway should be able to wear him down and get inside. But this Mitchell is a special kid. They love him up here in Steubenville.
Whoa.
He caught Conway coming in right there.
He's trying to figure him out here right now.
Nice combinations. And this is a open division, 132 pounds. I tell you who used to fight some wars, Matt Conway and Johnny Spell. Johnny got a growth spurt last year. He jumped up about 10, 15 pounds heavier than Matt Conway, but they used to be in the same weight class, and they used to go at it.
Oh, yeah.
They used to go at it, yeah. But look at Matt's eyes in there. Look at him. He's always concentrating. But it's tough to fight somebody taller than you.
Right. Looks like he has about 8 to 10 inches on him.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, Mitchell got his church socks on. Conway just caught him with a left hook.
What, did they go up to his knees?
It sure does. Nice left hook. So that left hook is starting to come. He's starting to find a home for that left hook. Another hook. Nice right hand by Mitchell. Ooh, nice combination. Nice combination.
Hey, we got Andy Sebastian here. Hey, Andy, what do you think of these fighters in the 132 here?
These are two sharp fighters. I know them both. Matt, of course, nice. Is a amateur veteran. Glenn Mitchell's from Ohio, but Steubenville. He's talented too. But the better fighter in there, I think, is Matt Conway because he's skilled and he really knows how to fight.
Thanks, Andy.
We got a brother over there with the sunglasses on.
Well, it was sunny out there, wasn't it?
Ain't nothing wrong with the shades, brother. You got Babyface Allen over there, former super middleweight champ of the world, working with the kids in Steel Valley. You got referee extraordinaire John Flanagan, a third man in the ring. Who'd you get that first round to, Al Levine, the talking machine?
I don't know. It's close. It was close on that. Maybe Conway there with a couple of his punches.
Yeah. Wow.
He seems the aggressor here. He must have hurt.
Yeah. He's getting that little Tasmanian little devil problem. Back in him.
They're using that whole ring in this fight, not like some of the others.
Yeah, they sure are. Nice body shot by Conway. Nice right hand. Everything's starting to land right now, and he's starting to see, and he got a great corner. Wow, nice left hook.
There was one. You called.
Was that on the chin or the neck?
I think neck.
Okay, still hurts.
You think? A little slap.
Nice. And you know Conway will never get tired in the ring. This man's a wrestler. You talking about the road work you got to do to get the weight down for wrestling.
He has some calves there, too.
Oh, yeah. He's winning that battle.
Oh. He can't get his socks up to the calves.
But Steubenville last summer actually had an event out there, and in the main event fighter was Mitchell.
So, oh, yeah?
Yeah.
It must be pretty good because look at his shorts have his name on the front of it, Glenn, G-L-E-N-N.
Sure enough. And we know the problem some of the football players was having in Steubenville, so.
Yeah.
You know, it's too bad they got, it's a lot of great athletes in Steubenville, Ohio. It's too bad they're getting all that bad publicity lately.
That happens, sir. Those were some heavy punches there.
Sure enough. Heavy punches.
Your man Mitchell's still going at it. He's not giving up.
That one missed, but I think that Conway really took control of this round.
Where he keeps those gloves up high.
He sure does. Good body shot. Ooh, right under the floating rib. Al Levine will be in the blue corner, I think.
I don't know. We'll see what happens here.
But the one thing we got to take in consideration, we're not seeing all the angles that your judges are seeing. So different places, maybe all these scoring shots we're seeing, they're not seeing. So.
Yes.
Wow.
And they're giving us great action right in front of us,
sure
Smoking
enough.
Jim.
Sure
Where's
enough.
The white on Mitchell's glove? How's he scoring any points?
Yeah,
the last kid
point.
With blue gloves lost.
That's true.
You know what? I might go to the red corner. Nice punches there.
Wow. Nice left hook by Mitchell.
And he's
very powerful for.
And he has nine lives.
Very powerful for his belt.
He throws a wicked wide left and right.
Yeah.
That comes around.
How do you score this one? It looks pretty close.
Yeah.
Like that one that took an hour to get. Yeah.
Wow, nice combination.
Too close to call for me, Smoking Jim.
Well, I got Matt Conway winning pretty comfortably, although that's my favorite fighter. Ooh, nice left hook.
Looks like you'll be going to that blue corner then. Or no, red, I mean.
Wow.
Whoa.
Came off,
bounced
off the ropes. That's good.
That was no roping, though. Mitchell's coming back.
Yeah, I tell you what, these are two very good young fighters.
They're both in shape. Look at this.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you don't see no body fat on Mitchell.
I'm going Conway. Just with that one.
Wow.
There we go. Yeah.
Ooh, nice right hand by Matt Conway.
I think he hurt.
Ooh, yeah. That overhand right is landing.
Yeah.
He found a home with that overhand right. Just barely missed it right there.
He's in such great shape. For Baltimore. All right, you get the winner.
gentlemen, Rosie Morales had relinquished the chance to fight for the title tonight. Because of that, I and some other people involved here felt he is the outstanding sportsman of the Golden Gloves.
All right, here it is, Al Levine, the talking machine. I tell you what, you're talking about two guys that's going to be pros eventually, and I tell you what, I'm nervous for Johnny Spell. Amani Everhart is one of the best fighters in the world. He could have went pro last year. Wow.
Let's see what happens.
Wow. They look like they both got a lot of respect for each other. Wow. Wow. You see that move by Amani Everhart?
Yeah.
You see how he's exploded back in after the break?
You hear how quiet it is here.
It is quiet. Ooh, that's right hand. All right, stop the fight. Oh, man, I don't want Johnny to get hurt. This Amani is just too good. He's the best fighter in the world. He could be a top 25 pro.
Really?
Amani Everhart, if he'd have turned pro last year, he could be a top. He went toe-to-toe with Sammy Vasquez when he was just a kid.
Wow.
Nice left hook. Right now, it's time to throw it.
He's throwing some punches. Not
he's good.
Johnny's throwing a couple, too.
He's good, but he's in there with an older guy that should be a professional. Johnny's still in high school.
17, folks.
Oh, my goodness. I'm nervous because this guy, Johnny Spell's got a bright future. He's probably the best. He's probably got the most potential ever seen of an amateur fighter in this area. And I don't want him in there getting hurt against Amani. Amani can go pro and within a year fight for the world title.
Really?
Yeah, he's that good.
He's that good.
He's that good. Johnny Spells just came with a nice jab.
He's protected himself.
Yeah, yeah. Nice body shot by Johnny Spells. Oh, Amani. And always remember,
there were Amani, two nice punches
but
there.
But Amani's a slow starter. Nice right hand by Spells. Yeah, and we know he's very well coached.
You can hear his dad in the corner there.
Uh-huh. And don't forget, this is the defending state champion. Amani Everhart's the defending state champ. He didn't turn pro this year because he wants to win the national championship. Oh, nice.
Yeah, but Johnny's, look at Johnny Spells.
I tell you what, this last 30 seconds, Johnny Spells won this last 30 seconds. Wow. Johnny's starting to warm up. Now, Amani's a slow starter. Wow. Wow. He don't want to get caught, though. He don't want to get caught.
You know what? Spells is getting more confident. I don't know if that'll cost him.
Don't forget, Everhart gives the first round away. Everhart don't start warming up till round two. Ooh, did he get hurt? Did Spells get hurt right at the end? Spells just got a right hand.
Did he get right now? Look at him.
I tell you what,
he's in shape.
Here come Amani. Now here come Amani. He always puts on the gas in round two.
Okay.
Wow. See that power punch.
Right.
See, none of those punches are getting through. Look at the guard up on Amani. Left hook.
This is a great fight.
Yeah. Ooh.
Spell's got a couple nice ones in there. He slipped them in there.
Good.
Look at him. You see how close he went in so they didn't mean anything?
Ooh, wow. What a fight. What a fight.
This may be the best fight of the night.
I'm afraid for Spells don't want to mix it up, I don't think, with Everhart, although he's doing well. Well, he made Everhart miss bad. Oh.
I don't know. I think you're underestimating Spells a little bit.
I'm nervous. Ooh, a body shot. Ooh, did you see that body shot?
Yes, he missed an over.
Oh, he just hit him with a right hand.
He didn't hurt him.
He came back.
Spells is coming back,
Spells,
like you said.
Looking good. He's looking good. I just don't want him to get hurt.
He's taking a couple of those punches.
I just don't want him to get hurt in there. Eberhard can fight Sammy Vasquez right now.
Right.
Nice, nice.
Look at Spells is protecting himself.
Yeah. But
look at he just come back.
But this is a guy, Eberhard, who, ooh, nice right hand by Spells. Ooh. See, look at that. See, Eberhard is a guy that he is just warming up right now.
Ooh, right.
That was a good body shot. Was that a little low?
Yeah. Look a little bit. Just a little.
Boy, Spells talented. Oh, does he got skills.
It looks like he's gaining some confidence here.
And these are two of my favorite fighters. Boy, I hate that they have to be in the same weight class. All these different weight classes, why they got to fight each other?
I don't know.
Ooh.
They're trading punches all over the ring. Look at this.
Here come Imani, though. See, Imani just keeps putting the pressure on. You know he ain't going to get tired. And he got a heart. He got a heart like Marvelous Marvin Hagler.
I don't think Spells is getting tired here either.
No. Ooh, but it's only round. Ooh, see that body shot.
Yeah.
Ooh, them
that
body
hurt
shots.
Him.
Yeah, that hurt me just looking at it. Oh,
he
made
just
him
missed.
Miss. Made him miss. This Spells is so talented.
I think he's learning right here.
Yeah. This is the way to learn. Everybody's waited for this fight. This should have been the main event because everybody was
Look
here
at
to
him.
See this fight.
He's slugging it
Ooh,
out with him.
Yeah. He got the better of that exchange.
Did you see that? And he moved away.
Now the judges like a guy that's putting on pressure. And don't forget, this is the defending champion.
Spells has been putting on pressure too. Look,
is he doing enough to take the title from the champ? Somebody got blood. Look, Eberhard got blood on his gloves.
Yeah.
Where's that coming from?
Might be from Spells.
All right.
Man,
that was close.
What a fight.
He hasn't fought in a long time. Maybe he might be getting tired. I don't think so. Wow. Good body shot. Wow. Wow.
Wow. Spells has gained some confidence.
Ooh, here come on. He done made Imani mad.
He did. Let's see what he got.
He made Imani mad. Look, he made Imani
mad. They're both
mad.
Hitting, buddy.
Yeah. Wow. Wow. That was a good move. Wow.
Look at Spells.
Okay. Ooh. Whoa.
Spells is in control here.
But yeah, but can he? Oh,
no, that was a good one.
I don't think it hurts Spells, though.
No.
Oh, here it comes. Oh, this is a rumble. Ooh,
right here is where
shot.
You got to handle this. Oh, Spells did.
The judges is looking close. Whoever wins this last minute and a half. Oh. Wow. I am so impressed with Johnny Spells. I never thought he could go three rounds with the great Imani Eberhard.
He is, but he's giving him everything he can ask for.
I tell
Look
you
at
what,
him.
These guys, we may be looking at maybe the greatest.
Look at him. You see what Spells is doing. He's playing a little bit.
It looked like Eberhard got the best of that exchange.
Spells got his hands are down.
The judges don't like that. Ooh, he made
wow.
him miss. Oh, this is a close one. I got
smoking. He's right. There's Eberhard again and again.
Ooh, he got him against the rope.
Yeah,
nice.
No, he
move.
Spun right
that
out. That's the move you talk about.
This could be the greatest amateur gold glove fight of all time. Both of these guys are going places in the future.
Spell's got to pick it up a little bit at the end if he can to protect himself.
Well,
there's Eberhard.
He's not going to get the decision against Eberhard. He'll never get the decision against Eberhard. Eberhard's putting the pressure on. He's older. He's the defending champ.
Right. Eberhard is tired.
No. He just got the tired look. See? He got the tired
okay.
look. Look at him. He's starting to open
yeah,
up.
Yeah, he is.
He's actually mad. He's actually mad right now. I'd like to see
His
Johnny.
His experience is coming out here.
Johnny may want to hold on. Oh, Eberhard storm with mean intentions. Imani storm everything with mean intentions. Uh-oh. Ooh, nice right hand.
Nice hit.
Nice right hand that backed him up. And you see how Spells knows how to hold and turn?
Yeah.
I tell you what, this guy, this is a gifted fighter.
Man.
Both of them are gifted
Can't
fighters.
Judge this one. This is close, Smoking Jim. I don't care what you say, buddy.
No, it's a very
it's
close,
close
fight. Yeah, but in a close fight, you give it to the champ.
I agree with you there. Spells John. Is giving him everything he wanted, though.
Oh,
look at him.
Oh, maybe Amani. Is Amani tired or is he faking? Oh,
he's tired.
Ooh,
he's nice tired.
Shot. Oh, here it is. They hug. Hey, what
a
good
fight.
Interview. It's going to be a good interview.
You go get it, buddy. Whoa.
You're on your way to Philadelphia, and who's going? From the Blues!
What I tell you, buddy. I kept telling them Spells took it to him. There you go, folks. Upset of the day.
Smoking Jim Frazier, Steel City Sports World. I tell you what, I was so scared in there. Amani Everhart was a defending state champion. Could have went pro. Went toe-to-toe with Sammy Vasquez a few years back. One of the greatest fighters ever in southwestern Pennsylvania history, and you just beat him. Please tell everybody in the city of Pittsburgh your name and how proud you are right now.
My name is Jordan Spellchain out of Northside Fitness. I just feel good. Feel me? I'm getting ready to go to States. Just beat one of everybody's favorite in Pittsburgh. Didn't think it was going to happen, but had to do my thing. I tried my best. Things came out my way.
And I was scared to death. I almost threw in the towel before the fight started. But I tell you what, I never thought I could meet anybody that could go three rounds with Amani Everhart, let alone beat him. And I think you were confident the whole time going in.
Yes, I was kind of confident. Feel me? I just had to do what I had to do. Stay confident the whole fight, even in the third round when we was going at it. I just had to do my thing.
And I tell you what, your dad is your trainer, and he told me the blueprint for the fight beforehand, and you followed it to the T.
Yep. You feel me? We just had to stay on this outside. We did the whole little routine we was training for all week. We just had to do what he said worked.
And last question before we let you go, your dad always told me.
No one's going to be close. I'll tell you what, I told Darren in the corner, I said, I think Johnny got this tonight. Good job.
Thank you.
And your dad told me that you could be one of the youngest ever to go to Nationals, but you got one step first. You going to win that state of Pennsylvania title next week?
Yep, I'll be right in Philadelphia winning that to get to Nationals.
All right, good luck to you, champ.
Proud of you, man. Definitely good fight.
Smoking Jim Frazier, Steel City Sports World. I'm here with the greatest trainer on the planet, former national champion and undefeated professional fighter, Darren Dolby. Hey, Darren. I thought it was a close fight. On ringside, I had Amani Everhart winning, but it could go either way. How did you see it?
I seen those Spells. He did a hell of a job. He did a great job. He deserved to win. It kind of got close at first, but Spells just pulled away with it. I mean, he boxed sharp. He countered sharp. You know, he kept his punches tight. He did a good job. His dad worked with him good for that. And his dad thought I was going to be really working with Tay for this fight to get him ready. I worked with him a little bit, but I couldn't get him the way I wanted to. It wasn't long enough. Not enough time for me to get him ready like I wanted to.
All right. Thanks. I appreciate you, Darren.
Okay, Jim. Is that all right?
Good. Very good.
Thanks
a lot. Good job. But we're here with the trainer of the year, trainer of the century, former great, great fighter, amateur and professional. And I tell you what, you laid out the blueprint for this fight. I was so scared, I almost threw in the towel before the fight. I never thought anybody could go three rounds with Amani Everhart. And your guy did it. Not only did he do it, you called it exactly the way it went.
Yeah, because I knew he had him. You know, we've been around a while. He's been around a while, but all the other times we were up against him, we were smaller than him. And I seen that he was having problems with his power then. I said, well, he's going to have problems with your power today. You the same size as him this time. You know, we were kids last time when we sparred him.
Now, Amani is the defending state Golden Glove champion. Could have turned pro last year. Could be an undefeated pro right now. And your kid is, what, a junior in high school and he just beat him?
Yes. I mean, he's good. And like I promised you before, we were going to walk away with seven Golden Glove titles, but we walked away with nine. Everybody in my gym is a Golden Glove champ.
I tell you what, you're the trainer of the year. I appreciate your time. I can't wait to talk to you on the next show. All right, we got Vinny. What an upset.
Wow.
You called it. You called it.
Told you, I thought he was the aggressor, buddy.
Now, who's winning this fight so far? Caleb is tough. Vinny.
Vinny's been taking it to him, too.
Now, Vinny has some shoulder problems. He had a shoulder operation. Vinny, 3 years ago, was the state Golden Glove champion. He won the state Golden Gloves. He got a little rock. I call him the Southside Rocky. He was a former outstanding football player and wrestler at Brashear High School. His dad is here, but Caleb Parrish got a lot of fights, and he's a tall guy. Everybody that Vinny fights seems to be tall.
Yeah.
But you got Vinny winning his first round?
Yes, I put Vinny winning that, yeah.
And you've been calling him left and right.
Just lucky here, Smoking Jim. No expert here.
And I just picked a winning ticket.
Whoa.
Vinny is tough. We got the Southside Rocky.
He throws some heavy punches there.
I am still in shock. I never thought I'd see the day that anybody could beat Imani Eberhardt. And again, according to my unofficial scorecard, I had him winning. So I still
close.
Didn't see him lose.
It was close. My card, all spells.
Uh-oh. He almost put him over here because
I know.
That's a baby bull right there.
I see that.
Ooh, nice body shot. Nice.
Nice head shot.
Okay. Wow. Nice.
Boy,
that was
body punches got to be doing some damage.
And he just threw a double hook to the body, double left hook to the body. That's a good combination. And don't forget, Teddy is over there. And I talked to Johnny Spell Sr. He said he had 9 winners from his gym. Everybody won from his gym.
Wow.
9 winners. So he got to be the trainer of the year, wouldn't you think?
I would think.
Look at the back on Vinny. He got a back like a bodybuilder, don't he? He can fly with that back.
That's
huh?
No baby back.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. If they go,
there's some wrestling.
Yeah.
Called that.
See, Caleb Parrish held his left hand, but Vinny still had his right to throw right. Punches. You know. And Vinny don't lose when his dad's here. His dad's here. His dad's a tough guy. Mr. Massalero, yeah.
Wow.
Right hand. See,
you know what? He looks like Rocky. He got hurt a little.
Yeah, he comes back. See, what's happening, Parrish's punches is getting there because he got a longer reach.
Right.
But this is a war. This is a war.
Caleb's face now. He's ready to kill.
Yeah. Well, you don't want to run in there. You don't want to run in there on Vinny.
There they come, Jim.
Yeah. Yeah.
Smoking, get ready.
Wow. Mm-mm-mm. Too bad we didn't see JT fight tonight, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nobody'd show up to fight him, I heard.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, the buses don't run on Sunday to Monroeville.
No. I got room for a couple.
His opponent's still at the EBA. And I felt bad for Jimmy Savetic, Mad Dog Jimmy Savetic.
Oh, yeah.
You know, great trainer. Darren Dolby, another great trainer.
Right.
But I tell you what, they gave no excuses. They felt that Johnny Spells won. I did not, but it was. I was proud of him.
You did.
And I couldn't have been more proud. I never thought I'd have lost money.
To go three rounds, let alone 6, 8, 10, 12.
I think it's the money. Just a guess.
Monty's leaving.
Monty Eberhardt is leaving the building. I feel bad for the guy. Like I said, he could be a professional fighter right now.
Right.
But.
Whoa.
But like I always say, the only thing square in boxing is the ring.
Right.
Ooh, nice to the cup by Vinny.
Yeah, he did all right. It's keeping that jab away from him.
Now he just hit him on the shoulder. That's not a scoring punch, even though he hit with the white of the glove. Nice right hand. Really? That had to score, right?
Yeah. They're trading those punches.
They sure are. The crowd is getting on the ref.
Yeah.
You either get on the ref or the quarterback. There's no quarterback here, so the ref got to take all the beating. Nice combination by Benny. This is too close to call. Another right hand by Benny. It's going to come down to the heart of the Southside Rocky. What happened? He got hurt. Benny got hurt. Oh, was that a slip or knockdown?
He got hit.
You see his legs?
Got rubbery.
His legs are gone. His legs are gone.
Unless he's cramping up. If I'm Benny. His legs are gone.
If I'm Benny right now and I'm holding, what I would do, if I'm Benny, I'm staying against the ropes and I'm fighting off the ropes just like that. Fight off the ropes because his legs are gone.
Yeah.
His legs are gone. Where's the bell?
I think he's cramped up.
How much time is left?
I don't know.
Levine, the talking machine?
We need a bell.
Ooh, nice right hand by Benny. Nice. What, hard? That's all hard. That's the Southside Rocky. Because here's nothing near.
His legs, he can't move. He's in trouble going back.
Now, right now, if Pear's catching with a right hand, Vinny almost did a little wrestling move there.
Yeah.
Get him against the rope. Oh, he tried to throw an uppercut.
He's wrestling him a little bit.
He's going to warn him for holding. No, he took a point away. The referee took a point away for holding.
That could be sided.
That might be the difference. Wow, that might be the difference. Wow.
Then he got to come back. No, if he doesn't, that could have changed the whole fight.
Yeah, nice. Wow, nice. What heart. The Southside Rocky. This ain't Rocky Marciano. This is Rocky Graziano.
Whoa. He's hitting him with
all heart. His dad's there.
Yeah.
Because he know he might have to go another three rounds with his dad if he lose.
He might have to walk home.
Boy, this is a long round. We want to hear that bell.
Lost. They lost the bell.
Ooh, Vinny, what a right hand. But Parrish walked through it.
Nice.
Oh, there it is. That's going to be too close to call. Wow. Oh, they both won. Draw? Oh man, I would like to have that bag. There go the Southside Rocky! Vinny!
Go.
Former state champion. Proud of Vinny. That was a great, great fight. Let me circle that.
Congratulations.
What a great fight by Monty
Eberhardt. I did not. I think what happened was Spells came here. Third round he lost, arguably, but he lost. He lost. The only thing I can hope for that Spells keeps growing and becomes like a light heavy, because he's a very, very good boxer. He's slick. Money had taken off too much weight. I mean, no excuses made. Spells just really looked good, I thought.
Well, I tell you what, Jimmy, you've been around for 40 years. Is Johnny Spells one of the true outstanding young fighters that you've seen at that age?
Yes, I think it is. He reminds you of a little Muhammad Ali, doesn't he?
He sure does.
Yeah,
He has, a beautiful magic in his feet and his hands. And he got that reach. He's built. He's strong. Monte, you know, we knew we couldn't let, I said, don't let him get in rhythm. Once he gets in rhythm, he's a very dangerous fighter.
He did.
And Monte just couldn't get into his rhythm. And Monte took off a little bit too much weight, and it showed. Okay.
All right. Great. Thanks, Mad Dog. Jim. Mad Dog Jimmy Savetic.
And I tell you what, Wolf from the Butler Cubs has already advanced, but there's no way I put my fighter in with Isaiah Guy. He is unbelievable. And I tell you what, Isaiah Guy may have a fight down the road with Little Teddy.
Whoa.
We could be looking at two outstanding guys coming up. This is now the time to get in the box. You see all these great young guys coming up.
And Jim, I'm glad to be aboard.
Pittsburgh's going to be the mecca of boxing. People don't have to go to Las Vegas to see great fights.
Hold it. Thanks to BPTV, Dave Cable, Aaron Ward for being here, filming all this great action and letting us talk, which we're both good at that.
And the one thing you'll find in Pittsburgh is a lot of white-collar brawlers.
And you'll see more of that with Jimmy Savetic.
Yeah, this Isaiah guy is...
What do you want to say, Jimmy?
I want to say the weights don't look right. Yeah. One guy looks a little bit too big.
Heard that from Mad Dog. Lil Z's having a good time over there.
What's this one of Little Z's stable?
Yeah.
Look how intense Little Z is.
Yeah, he sure is.
Wow, you not only scout, you do psychological evaluations.
Sure enough.
We're getting everything.
I think Vinny's waiting for the interview over there. He's over there with his dad. Yeah. So. Uh-oh, Little Z forgot to put the mouthpiece in. Little Z forgot that?
That can't be happening.
Oh, no, they got a snap on the headgear. That must not be the head. They bought everything from neck down to toe, but they messed up with the headgear. That guy looked professional, don't he?
Yeah.
Wow. They going to war. Uh-oh. This is another kid. I wonder if he goes to school. Isaiah Guy is like a little professional. I wonder if he ever goes to school.
I met him before the fight, and they told me how good he was. His brother was telling me how good he is. The kid there with Little Z.
But when you're that good, you really need school.
Yes. Go to school. Go to school. You can be like Smoking Jim someday. Get your degree at Cal U. Go to school. You didn't hear me? Go to school.
Keep moving.
Wow. He's a counter-punching machine.
Yeah, you go to school to get a job, and this guy's job is going to be a professional boxer. Right? You can see it already. Look at that. I mean, this guy is good. He got the right name, too, because I keep calling him Guy. This guy is good. The prophet. Wow.
And he already got the USA patch. He must have fought some national level competition.
Little Z's on tomorrow. We'll ask.
Okay.
You know what? Another stone cold lock. Thanks. Let's watch some boxing.
Nothing against school, but when you're that talented, why in the world do you need school? Get up, do your road work, go back, take another nap, eat breakfast.
That'll help make him a little more worldly.
Well, I read a book where you can watch the movie, right?
Read the book.
They're going to fight her, huh? Is he just getting here? Did he miss his fight?
No, he was here.
He has a bright future.
Yes, he does. Doesn't he have that unorthodox style?
He sure does, and he's another guy out of
Ted Rod 51 Gym.
No, I think he's out of the North Side. Johnny Spells.
Johnny Spells, you're right.
North Side Police Athletic League. I got to go visit there.
We got invites at all the gyms, just so you know.
Yeah. Nice fight. Beautiful fight.
But we do have a winner of the bout today. And the winner is from the Red Corner.
I like the look in Wolf's eyes. Wolf takes that serious. It's going to be good. Smoking Jim Frazier, Steel City Sports World. I'm here with the future. Please tell all your fans in the city of Pittsburgh your name and where you're from.
These guys, they fill up a truck.
From Homestead, and my name is Isaiah the Prophet Guy.
And I tell you what, the last time I talked to you, you didn't sound like you were afraid to fight anybody. Is there anybody you're afraid to fight?
No.
And they can?
They can't get it. Anybody can get it because I'm the cameraman. Mexicans, Africans, Canadians.
I like it. And I tell you what, I got my man, Zach, over here. You called it. I tell you what, I like to buy some stock in Isaiah Guy's future. He's all that.
Thanks. He works real hard. He trains with my buddy, JB Reagan Boxing, 51 Boxing, Still Valley Boxing, World Class Boxing, South Park Boxing. I ran out of boxing because we got so much boxing, but he is the future, and if he keeps working like this, you're going to see him around for a long time to come. And same with this little guy right here, he's the future too.
Well, I tell you what, please let everybody know where Reagan Boxing's located.
We're out of Homestead. We both live in Homestead.
And I tell you, and this is your son right here?
Yes, sir.
I seen the spin move that he did in the ring. I think he's a future Gateway Gator running back.
He might be. What's up, JB? You think so?
And what's next for Isaiah?
Maybe a fight next week and then the state championships in Reading.
All right, sounds.
Junior Olympics.
And as we close out, what's your weight class and how old are you?
My weight class is 95 and I'm 13.
And I tell you what, would you like to fight professionally one day?
Yes.
I think you got a bright future.
Finally, we gotta get this kid out to Sip Sports Bar Monday night, 7:30. We had Little Teddy, we had Spells, we had everybody out. We gotta get the Prophet out, man.
Are they coming?
They're coming. And you know I'll be there.
Sounds good. See you tomorrow. Thanks, Zach. Sorry about that, sir. Yeah, here. Ooh, what a right hand.
Biggest bout of the night, buddy. Look at these guys.
When you're that size, one punch can take a guy out. Ooh, you see that body shot?
I felt it. I didn't see it. I felt it.
And these guys are over 200 pounds.
You think? Two plus.
John Flanagan got his hands full. The referee, he's a great referee, but some big boys to break up. This guy got a lot of endorsements. He got more endorsements on his back than a NASCAR driver.
Yeah, he does.
And who are these guys? Brian Kelly is a tough kid.
Yeah.
Brian Kelly.
One boxing.
Yeah, Brian Kelly's a tough kid. Yeah, yeah, that's Brian Kelly. He's a tough kid. That could be why Mike Shook didn't fight this year. Brian Kelly's tough. Wow. Yeah, he's a tough kid. And he's fighting a guy from IUP. My cat could get a degree from IUP, buddy. Talk about a party school.
How do you know all these schools? When are we going to be up at Cal U there, Smokey Jim?
May 3rd to see Lightning Rod Salka. Ooh, what a right hand by Kelly. And Zim Rose walked through it, but I think his knees just buckled a little bit.
Just a little.
Ooh, wow. Kelly. Wow.
I think he said wow on that.
Mm-mm-mm. Wow. The lights is going out. I tell you what, wow. Kelly's turning the lights out in this place.
They're back.
Oh, the rope saved Zim Rose. Oh, if Kelly would have hit him, the rope saved him.
No.
Did you see Kelly's right hand gets tangled up in the ropes?
Yeah.
That was a knockout shot. Wow.
That it did. They're throwing some punches.
These guys can fight in a phone booth. There's no such thing as phone booths anymore.
No, where do you find one? And this is our last fight of the night.
And I tell you what, Little Z just booked Isaiah Guy and some of those guys for the show tomorrow.
Did he?
Yeah.
Nice.
I guess they'll be coming late like him.
Jeez. I think we're supposed to be done at 6:30.
Maybe a wedding reception is coming in here at 7 o'clock. Wow. Now, what would you do if somebody's throwing shots like that?
Wow.
Other than cover up?
Wow. Move. Move a little bit.
Wow. Wow. Now, this is for the open division title. The winner gets to go to Philadelphia and fight.
I think they'll be ready after this.
Another guy that would have been fighting here tonight was J.D. You know, you met him earlier. J.D. was a good heavyweight. But in the last year, he got his own business.
Okay.
And he's been putting all his time in becoming a business owner. What's that, an entrepreneur?
Yes, very well spoken, like our man Little Z.
One thing. Wow.
Oh, my God.
Is Kelly getting a little tired?
Yeah, looks like it.
And one thing, when you throw a lot of power punches,
oh my,
it tires you out.
How about when you're catching them?
And one thing I can say, anybody that comes on our show at SIPS, seems like good karma happens for them. Johnny Spells.
Exactly.
I'm still in shock.
Hey, it was well deserved.
It sure was. But I was nervous.
I know.
Because, see, you never seen a Monte fight.
No, I didn't.
Oh. But like Jimmy Savetic said, he had to lose too much weight.
Is that what it was? Here they come for us, there, buddy. We got them right in front of us. Is he going to be on our show?
He may.
Oh, we didn't ask.
Well, I did ask, but he said he might have one girl that may come. He had to ask her yet, so. Wow.
Good body shot.
These guys will be spitting up blood, huh?
Oh, yeah, right at us. Ooh. Here we go.
There's some big boys in there. What do you estimate that weight? You played offensive center. What do you estimate that weight?
They're in the 230s to 240. Right there, buddy. I think they're getting a little tired smoking, Jim.
Sure enough. I think Kelly got the fight. But boy, I tell you what, they went toe to toe. Both these guys left everything in the ring, Al.
That they did. And they're still throwing those heavy punches. I'm getting tired watching here.
Sure enough. Wow. Man, this is like haymakers.
Oh, yeah.
And these guys would be perfect for the white collar brawlers, you know?
Do they have a job?
No.
Can't be a white collar brawler. You gotta have a job with a white collar. Wow, here we go.
Wow. Everybody's excited. They don't have a place to sit anymore, but they're excited. Ooh.
Wow, the crowd's going crazy here.
Ooh, are they fighting 4-minute rounds or is it three?
They threw away the bell.
Wow. There was no hugging at the end of that.
No.
But there was a lot of blood being exchanged.
Wow,
Kelly.
Wow.
The red corner.
Red corner.
Almost all red corners. Wow, IUP. That was close. It was a close one to call.
Yeah.
A lot of people thought maybe.
That one fooled me, Smoking Jim. I think that's the first one I missed.
Kelly's leaving the building. He's not real happy right now, but he didn't want to go to Philadelphia anyway, probably. He wants to go to Philadelphia.
Or anytime.
Hey, Al Levine, as we wrap up and close, hey, I enjoyed doing the broadcast with you. I didn't do all 18, 20 fights like you did.
You killed me.
Are you going to be able to talk tomorrow?
I'll be able to talk.
All right, Al Levine, the Talking Machine, and Smoking Jim Frazier. Catch us on Verizon Channel 32 for
Pittsburgh Sports Line.
There you go. Thanks, Al. Great job.
Great job, Smoking Jim. And see us on YouTube. Friend us on Pittsburgh Sports Line on Facebook. Hit that like button.